Hey guys, it's me, Andrew Lai. Last time, I talked about my experience playing with Japanese airsofters at Hazard Hiroshima. It was truly a huge culture shock, especially seeing how they adjusted their playstyle due to the restrictions on toy gun velocity output, which really made the game that much more enjoyable. I also really enjoyed the countryside of Japan. It was quiet, but refreshing. But for today's episode, let's dive deeper and join a very Japanese exhibition at the Hiroshima Industrial Hall Fujisawa Sho. Speaking of Japanese self-defense forces, you can still see their booth along with those anime works from a few years ago, like Fantasy Self-Defense Force. Actually, just yesterday, it seems like the author was here to promote his work. At these kind of exhibitions, it's almost a given that there will be recruitment booth for active or retired units.
The armored vehicle I'm currently sitting inside of belongs to the 36th Regiment of the JGSDF. And as you can see, because this is an airsoft and military show, there are many young people that are enthusiastic about anything that is military. So the recruitment office has set up a booth over here. And you can see all the officers here today have been very engaging with all the visitors, as well as all the young people coming to the show. Telling them about the career opportunities and potentials in the Japanese self-defense force. I'm a little bit too tall for this vehicle, I think.
Remember the review video that we made earlier that combined the anime Legolas? Survival games and anime mangas are both considered subcultures in Japan, and products combining those two are very popular. In addition to Fantasy Self-Defense Force combined with Self-Defense Forces, there are many related products from various anime works being sold. If you love anime and are looking for some related patches or products, Japan is the place to go. Okay, this is the first booth we'll bump into, and this little lady right here, she's the one we saw from SHOT Show, if you remember that. However, I think they got some like very cool products in comparison to just the regular airsoft products. Because instead of just selling guns, in Japan they do sell a lot of side accessories and they make them extra cute. For instance, the one that you see is that when you play airsoft, you get like really sweaty. This time you would need a very nice towel. And this one is just not a regular towel. This is a specially made with the, it's called the Imabari towel. Imabari, sorry. The Japanese man towel, yes. So the beautiful thing about these is that this thing sucks in water super fast and it dries super fast as well. So if you have one of these cute towels, you can just wipe yourself very quickly, and once you wash it, it dries super quick too. Get one. Meow. There are also booths that combines toy guns with traditional Japanese culture, featuring accessories that integrate various elements of traditional Japanese culture into the modern guns. They are very beautiful.
This booth right here, it is so cultured. Look, part of the reason I love Japanese culture is because they can turn everything into their culture. When you talk about guns, when you talk about gun accessories, take a look here. That is absolutely amazing. Golden shiny stuff. And not just golden shiny stuff. Check it out. They got mark engravings onto this, and that's the traditional Japanese culture stuff onto those type of accessories. So you can turn the gun into a very modernized looking, but at the same time, got lots of Japanese culture inside. Look at this 1911 right here. It's got the sakura and also got the compensator, everything, and also the pistol grip. I think this gun looked absolutely beautiful. And also when you get a closer look onto the small accessories here, like such as magazine plates and things like that, wonderful, looks absolutely amazing. The pistol, they have the golden stuff and they also have the silver stuff. Super cool. I actually want a piece of that.
From part of our market research, it was found that the Japanese market had an endless desire when it comes to full trademark guns, or sometimes historical guns. So this time in Japan, I met my old friend Trench Airsoft, whom I had known from Taiwan MOA, and they do produce some historical guns.
来来来，哎，这边这摊就不用问了哈，为什么？台湾人直接拍就对了。我们也来日本了，也来日本了。 Trench Airsoft， 我们 MOA 隔壁的好邻居。
这次也来日本展览，你可以看一下他们做的墙，现在真的虽然是小厂商，但是做的东西其实真的已经很有水准。你看这个，这一次的话，对对对，我们带了我们的隔壁的酒吧，那隔壁的酒吧刚才开场一个小时就被订走，
哦，直接被订走，
被订走了，哦，所以现在我们拍的是我们做的 K 98
K 98
大家最熟悉的 K 98 K，
对，那我们也是一样，是全实木，然后。
机夹和下枪身的部分是新合金，其他部分我们进口的钢原木做钢的套件，然后升级的套件也都在里面安装好了。对，所以回去就不用再想说啊会有什么坏掉啊，或者是要升级的部分。
所以就一开盒就是 ready
了。对，然后 hub 跟管皮都是通 VSR 的。LP
哦，这个就对了，这个就对了。所以。
有想要用 4UAD
的皮也可以装上去哦，装一下。That's NWS right there. That's a very interesting stock. And then once you hold on to it, it's actually quite comfortable. Maybe you can shoot a very tactical too. Want to try it? Good. Yep. You know, airsofting. It is indeed quite interesting when it comes to playing airsoft, because a lot of times it's not just shooting people, but at the same time it's more like cosplay, I would say. So carrying a real blade with you in a cosplay event, it will be not as ideal. Therefore, they have this very real looking plastic blade, which is not sharp at all. This thing is made out of plastic. However, it's got a very nice finish on top of that. So you can take a look. It's even got like holster on that. So let's say when you are playing an airsoft game, you want to pull out the blade like that. I wouldn't recommend you stab people with it, despite the fact that it is safe. However, though, it adds on a little bit extra taste to your game, and it's safe to play. See, they even got this type of holster thing. If you got really good with it, go like, blah, blah, blah. And yeah, hopefully you are not gonna injure anyone. However, still, don't scare the shit out of people though. We don't recommend that. Oh, this one. It's even got like very nice printing on top of that.
It's Rainbow Six Siege.
Oh, okay.
Japan's electronic game industry also brings some big effects to the airsoft markets. My personal favorite, the Biohazard series, in which Tokyo Marui produced quite a few models just based on the game. However, creative and sci-fi looking guns can also be seen here. Just like this one, a special air-compressed electromagnet valve fusion sniper rifle.
We saw something very, very, very special. This is a bolt action sniper rifle. However, I think this one is magnetically powered. Instead of pulling the bolt backward, you pull it forward to charge. It's
This is the way you load it. Once you load it this way, you pull the trigger. Oh, like it is super light. And then you can actually hear the click. And then if you want to reload, you pull this up. Instead of pulling it back, you push it forward. And then reload again. Whoa, this is so cool. And the entire gun, it is extremely light. It only weighs 1.5 kg or less. And also it is extremely easy to swap the, if you are left. Right now this is the lefty setting. However, if you wanna change the charging handle, all you need to do is just release it, switch to another side, and spin. And I think, oh, obviously, it takes BSR 10 magazines inside. So, I think this is something very, very innovative. And this one is even connected with the battery, since it is electric powered in some ways. Electric magnetically powered. Super cool. Arigato. Hi.
G&G also has a significant market here in Japan, with many stores selling their products. They also have a booth here. So let's take a look.
In the Japanese Hiroshima exhibition right here, we saw G&G, obviously. G&G, they are pretty popular in Japan. So again, these are their brand new lines of G&G products. We got their brand new folding, the type of M4 that actually you can easily fold it with. And the beautiful part is, where do you hide the batteries? Actually, the battery goes right inside this little chamber here that you can use a stick type, open the cap, then you can just put your battery inside. This is very innovatively designed because they actually managed to hide the wire and the cable right here, making the gun look extra clean, which I think that is a very, very good taste. Oh, actually, I've always wanted to try out this one. I think this gun right here, it is called the MCP-556. They have the submachine gun version. This one is the 556 version that uses standard M4 AEG magazines. Personally, I think this one has got a very nice look to it. Look very futuristic at the same time, quite comfortable to hold. Yeah, that's just their GBV line. No, all right. This one, it is the GBV version in which G&G just entered the GBV game. And now the bow, just feel the bow, it is extremely smooth. And this one, it can withstand like very, very cold temperature. Special rubber for that, literally on all the G&G guns. So overall, I think the gun feels extremely smooth. And if I want to test fire it, oh, with regular Japanese gas, it still functions in a pretty snappy fashion. Pretty decent, pretty nice. So this is the brand new G&G GBVR line. Last but not least, this one is also the gas gun. However, this one, it is a shotgun. It takes regular M4 magazines. However, the feed rate probably wouldn't follow up. So it's better that you use their proprietary M4 magazines that feeds faster. This gun, it shoots 5 shots. And then if you flick it, this is the 5 shots. You flick it here. That's 10 shots, and this one doesn't come with a hotbar. However, if you remove the cap here, that it reveals a Picatinny rail that you can add on to all sorts of stuff. And if you remove this mark suppressor here, that you can add into some, let's say, perhaps flash hiders or even like tracers into the suppressor area. Very cool little gun.
Previously, at the SHOT Show in the United States, we introduced the CAT system AEG, developed in collaboration with Arcturus. There is also an exhibition booth here. So again, let's take a closer look.
If you remember SHOT Show, the stuff we saw from Arcturus, we see a lot of CAT system in Japan. This is really absolutely amazing. And then something we didn't see back in SHOT Show, this one, they enter into the Speed QB area as well. This one, I think it takes the good old G&G ARP9 magazine. And this pistol grip right here, although it is an AEG magazine that has a motor inside, it is extremely comfortable to hold. And the gun has got that very modern look, and the rail, it's got, you can customize it the way you want it. And the coolest part is this type of stock. And again, they have the wire incorporated into this so that you can fit your battery and whatever into the stock right here. So, you know, when you are doing the Speed QB game, you can do like and do stuff like that, which I think this gun looks actually really, really cool, even to just take your regular airsoft game. See, now I don't need a riser anymore. No more riser shit. All I need to do is just do this. And then the sight is gonna align with my face. I can go like that. Super cool. And once again, for those of you who haven't seen the CAT system, what's so special about them? They are made with split tie gearbox, similar to the ICS version. However, something very interesting is they have a mechanical precocking inside the gun. And then once you take a closer look, they actually have showed this precocking mechanism on their image here. And you can even fine tune and adjust the treble inside by using this little hole, click a few times, and to make sure where the gear stops. Very, very amazing innovation.
I was just wondering what those guys are doing back on the stage. These are people dueling with laser guns on the stage. I want a piece of that.
You might be wondering what we are doing right now. Is we are actually doing some type of shooting game at the exhibition area. So this is like a type of laser tag that they allowed us to play on the stage. Dude, this is too cool. This is a one-time life experience. I've never experienced something like that. And now it seems like this company, they have the system that you can have your cell phone download the app, and then once you got their gun, the laser tag, now you can have the game over there on stage. How cool is that?
Laser tag on the go.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, laser tag on the go. I'm gonna destroy you.
We'll see about that.
Or we'll both embarrass ourselves in front of the entire show.
Look, I'm a small target, eh?
And I can shoot over the cover, see? You only shoot left and right, I get to choose the top too.
Let's see what happens. Hey. Ooh. I think I'm gonna try to shoot this way. I'm gonna cheat like this.
Start.
Yeah. Got it. Wait, really? I just died again. What? No.
You suck. This is terrible.
Yeah.
You're our champion.
Oh, yes. Hey. Yeah, giant. Yeah. Oh, it gets a little hot. I'm 65 HP. So bad. And then actually covering myself doesn't work. It still goes through.
No, if you cover yourself, it forces me to go to melee attack.
I was trying to shoot like this and eventually it didn't work.
No scratch.
No way.
Although the show wasn't big, and it didn't have that many fancy decorations to vendors' booth, but for some reason, I just really enjoy the vibe of it, and how energetic people are. It was a lot of fun to listen to the vendors introducing their product in a very passionate way. Proud and confident, yet very humble.
Okay, I'm doing the closing here since you get to see the entire area. Louis and Brandon are here. I want to say what's really amazing about this trip is that this is the first time the quad team that traveled together, and at the same time, I think the overall event is just absolutely amazing. They had the Hazard Hiroshima game yesterday and now the show today. What's really amazing is we saw a lot of familiar faces, you know. People play the game, and the second day they attend the event, and there are all the guys from the booth, they are super friendly and they are so nice to us. And at the same time, you can definitely see how passionate they are and the effort they spend on their products, how they represent it. The overall booth looked, despite the fact that it looked very simple, it's just desks and their products. However, the passion is unbeatable. So I have to say, I'm very, very touched throughout this entire trip and really enjoyed it. And hopefully one day we get to come back to Ezra Hiroshima and then play some more games here and really enjoy Airsoft.
Towards to the end of the video, the funny thing is, when you enjoy something, that time just passes speedy fast. I really want to spend a few more days here in Hiroshima and take a closer look at the countryside. But eventually, the party here is over this time. I will come back and visit for sure. And now, we got another party coming. Osaka City, here we go.